Have you ever seen an aircraft with two propellers rotating in opposite directions on a single shaft? This is called a contra-rotating coaxial propeller, an advanced technology used in aviation and other industries. But how does its mechanism work? Let's dive deeper. The concept of contra-rotating coaxial propellers first emerged in the late 19th and early 20th centuries, alongside advancements in aviation technology. One of the first engineers to develop this idea was Alexander Fyodorovich Mozhaisky, a Russian aviation pioneer who experimented with twin propeller aircraft designs. During the 1920s and 1930s, several engineers further developed this concept, particularly in helicopter and experimental aircraft designs. A major breakthrough in the history of contra-rotating coaxial propellers occurred in the 1940s when Nikolai Kamov, a Russian engineer, began applying this technology to his helicopter designs. Kamov successfully created helicopters with a coaxial rotor system that enhanced stability and eliminated the need for a tail rotor. The Kamov company became a leader in this technology, and many of their helicopters still use this system today, such as the Ka-50 Black Shark and Ka-52 Alligator. Aside from Russia, the United States and several European countries also experimented with this technology. One example of its application in military aviation is the Convair XFY Pogo, an experimental VTOL aircraft developed by the U.S. in the 1950s. Unfortunately, this design was not widely adopted due to the complexity of its mechanism. This system was also widely applied in bombers and large transport aircraft before jet engine technology became dominant. For example, the Tupolev Tu-95, a strategic bomber built by Russia, uses contra-rotating coaxial propellers to enhance power efficiency and reduce the torque effects of turboprop engines. This system allows two propellers to rotate in opposite directions while sharing the same axis. The mechanism operates using a dual shaft system where one layer of the shaft controls the first propeller, while the other layer controls the second propeller in the opposite direction. To achieve this effect, several methods are used, such as planetary gears, gear discs, or a three-way gear system. Planetary gears, or planetary gear train, consist of a central sun gear, multiple planet gears that revolve around it, and an outer ring gear. When the sun gear rotates, the planet gears also rotate while orbiting around it. This system allows efficient changes in speed and rotation direction and is often used in automatic transmissions in vehicles. Gear discs use interlocking gears mounted on discs. When one disc rotates, it drives the other in the opposite direction. This system is commonly found in industrial machine gearboxes and some coaxial propeller mechanisms. Three-way gear system employs three interconnected small gears. When one gear rotates, the others rotate in opposite directions, creating counter-rotation in two linked components. The contra-rotating coaxial system offers several advantages, making it highly beneficial in aviation and other applications. One of its key benefits is its compact design, as multiple rotating components share the same axis, making it ideal for fighter jets and helicopters with limited space. Additionally, this system provides better stability because the two propellers rotating in opposite directions balance aerodynamic forces, reducing vibrations and noise during operation. Another major advantage is higher energy efficiency, as the torque generated by one propeller is counteracted by the other, allowing for more stable flight and improved fuel efficiency. However, this system also has some drawbacks that must be considered. One of the main challenges is its complex mechanism, which requires high precision in design and manufacturing, making it more difficult to produce compared to conventional propeller systems. Additionally, the structure is generally heavier, which can impact overall aircraft performance. Lastly, maintenance and production costs are significantly higher due to the need for advanced lubrication technology and precise assembly, making it more expensive to operate and maintain.